Hey everybody, welcome back to the shop. In today's video, I will be unboxing, assembling, and reviewing the Longer LK4X 3D printer. This printer has a long list of features that supposedly makes it beginner friendly. If you'd like to find out if this is the printer for you, stick around. The unboxing of this printer was pretty straightforward. Everything was packaged nicely in custom cut foam. All of the parts, pieces, and tools were provided, including an instruction manual and some wrenches. One noticeable absence was the lack of side cutters that are normally included with 3D printers. The main parts of the printer were a little difficult to get out of the package, but that brings me to one of the main selling points of this printer, and that it is 95% assembled out of the box. I will elaborate on that here shortly. The first thing I noticed when I took the printer out of the box was the fact that it stands on these little legs here. At first I thought it may be to accommodate the size of the power supply, which is considerably larger than I've seen on other printers in the past, but the legs extend even farther than that. Only as I was assembling the printer did I realize the good design that these legs are. As you can see, in order to assemble the printer, you first must take the complete Z-axis gantry and attach it to the base using the four provided screws. The long legs of the LK4X gives you enough clearance to insert the screws while the printer is upright. No longer do you need to turn the printer on its side or try to figure out a way to balance it on its edge while you're attaching the uprights to the printer. Once the screws are started, then you can tilt the printer to one side or the other to give yourself access with your hex wrench in order to tighten the screws fully. Next, you attach the screen to the front of the printer. You attach the filament runout sensor and the filament roll holder to the frame. Attach the 3D touch sensor to the side of the extruder module, and then make all of the various electrical connections to hook everything together. And your printer is assembled and ready for printing. I was able to put this printer together in less than 15 minutes. Everything was labeled great, and the instructions were very clear on how you attach everything. This printer comes pre-configured with several features that are on most hobbyists' wish lists. First and foremost, it boasts a 32-bit silent motherboard. It also uses a 4-inch touchscreen interface. It has a spring steel PEI-coated print bed. Adjustable belt tensioning knobs, the aforementioned filament runout sensor, and 3D touch auto bed leveling system. The extruder is of the direct drive variety. It is not all metal construction. There is a piece of Teflon tube in the center of the melt zone, so you will be limited to about 230 degrees Celsius for your filament of choice. The hot end also uses a dual fan system to cool the nozzle, which I have not yet seen in any of the printers that I've reviewed. One thing that stuck out to me from the very beginning is how well the cables are routed and protected. They are sheathed in some type of foam sheathing, which acts as a type of cable chain and helps keep the wires from getting tangled into the moving parts and helps keep the stress on the wires at a minimum. The menu on this printer is very rudimentary and basic. That's not necessarily a bad thing, especially for beginners. It has some of the most basic functions for movement, temperature, loading and unloading your filament, leveling, and selecting which files to print. The auto level sequence is basically set up for you to be able to find your Z offset. It brings the nozzle down to where the 3D touch activates, and then you have to manually bring the print head down until the nozzle is touching your spacer of choice. And in my case, it's a post-it note. After you determine your Z offset, it asks you if you want to run a leveling sequence, which is not necessary at the moment because you will find that with this printer, it runs a 16-point auto level before every single print. Whenever I first test a printer, I like to see what is included on the provided SD card. There are a few files on this card, and so I select a calibration cube and I go ahead and run it and see how it turns out. So this is the test file. It looks pretty good, but that's to be expected. Now it's time to move on and slice some of my own files and see how that turns out. The longer LK4X is not currently supported in the most recent version of Cura. That would be, at the time of this filming, Cura 5. However, longer does provide an older version of Cura, version 4.12, that has a custom profile built specifically for this printer. So I wanted to do a few tests to see what would yield the best results. The first test I ran was I took the profile from a printer that I own that is very similar to this printer. So I went ahead and sliced this benchy and I printed it off using the settings from my other printer. And as you can see, it turned out pretty good. There is some issues in the Z-axis and there's lots of blobbing on the Z seam. And so I figure I can do a better job. So the next test is with the version of Cura and profile provided on the SD card. So I installed that version of Cura and I used the provided profile and sliced the file and printed it out. And here is the result of that print. This one turned out a lot better. However, I feel like there is still some room for improvement. So in Cura 5, I created a new printer based on an Ender 3 V2, which is very similar to the design of the longer LK4X. Then, referencing the profile provided with the printer on the SD card, I copied over all of the parameters and the start and end G code from the LK4X profile in Cura 4.12 into this new profile that I created. I sliced my benchy and printed it out. This is the best one yet. This benchy has the smoothest surface. The issues on the Z seam are no longer there. There are still a couple of anomalies. It is far from perfect, but it is definitely the best print out of the three. So now that I've figured out the best way to slice my files, I decided to try something a little bit more complex. So I sliced up this vase file and sent it to the printer. And I printed it using this beautiful tricolor silk filament that I found on Amazon. As you can see, the tricolor filament gives this print a chameleon effect, and I think it turned out beautiful. Beyond that, I printed a couple other things here and there just to test the printer's capabilities. I did a print in place file, which turned out great. And one thing that can be said about this printer is I had no failed prints. That first layer goes down perfect every single time, and I believe that's due to the fact that it auto-levels before every single print. The auto-level does add a little bit of time, especially if you're like me and you like to watch that first layer go down, but it is definitely the best way to guarantee that that first layer will not fail. So this is what I love about the longer LK4X 3D printer. This has got to be the most beginner-friendly printer that I've ever come across. You combine the ease of assembly and the simplicity of the menu on the interface, along with the repeatability of the auto-leveling system, and I feel like this printer would give you the best chances of having successful prints from the very beginning. I do like how easy this printer was to build, and it proves that you can make a printer that is mostly assembled and still have it ship in a reasonably sized package. I think it also should be noted how well managed the cabling is in this printer. A lot of other printer manufacturers leave it up to the user how they want to tidy up their cabling. I like how these cables come pre-wrapped and protected, and it really does seem like some thought was put into how the cables were routed. I mean, even the cable for the screen has these small clips that just help tidy it up and keep the cable from hanging or dragging on the top of the table, which is just a nice little touch. Here are a couple of the issues I have with this printer. The main issue I have with this printer is the simplicity of the menu. With a menu this simple, you can only get so much precision, quality, and performance out of your printer because there are many options and settings that you cannot tweak because they're not available in the menu. Some of the settings that I regularly work with that aren't on this menu would be things like PID tuning of your hot end and your heated bed, being able to calibrate your E-steps in all three directions, plus your extruder, being able to build and edit meshes using the auto-leveling system, and other smaller features such as giving you finer control over your Z offset. Right now you're limited to 0.1 millimeter increments, and sometimes 0.1 is just too big. I guess building on that complaint, I would prefer to have a printer that you can run the auto level sequence on once and have it save that mesh and then reload that mesh before every print, as opposed to the way this printer works where it builds that mesh every time it prints. I'm not sure if that's a limitation of this mainboard or if it's just the way that it was designed for this particular printer, but building that mesh in front of every single print ends up adding some time to the overall print time. And once again, I am a guy that likes to watch the first layer go down, and so that just adds an additional time to the time that I have to sit and watch my print to make sure that it's going to be successful. Those two things that I just mentioned are probably very minor complaints, and again, are complaints that come from somebody who likes to have a little bit more control over every aspect of his printer. If you are looking at this printer as a beginner, those things would be of no consequence to you. They don't interfere with your ability to learn how to use a 3D printer. And for, I would think, the majority of people that are interested in 3D printing, those concerns probably don't apply to them anyway. So in my opinion, despite those minor drawbacks that I just mentioned, I feel like this printer is probably the best printer that I have reviewed to date for beginners. I hope you enjoyed my review of the Longer LK4X 3D printer. I really do believe that this printer is one of the best printers I have come across for beginners. I feel like this printer was designed with all of these features combined to help a beginner and a casual user to have the most success right out of the box. The ease of assembly and the ease of use just lends to this idea of user-friendliness. Despite the lack of advanced controls, I'm a big fan of this printer. I've had nothing but success with it. I haven't had a failed print yet. I'm sure I may have it in the future, but the core design of this printer is to eliminate those pain points and those high learning curve areas to allow you to have the best chance of having successful prints right out of the box. I want to give big thanks to Longer for sending me this printer to do this review. If you are interested in finding out more about this printer or possibly buying your own, I will provide a link down in the description below and also in the comments. If you have your own opinions about this printer or the brand as a whole, go ahead and leave your comments down in the comment section below. I'd be interested in hearing your experience with this company. I want to thank you all for sticking around to this point. Once again, my name is Tom. This is Southpaw Workshop. Thanks for watching. I'll see you next time.